name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. The Lord be with you. Very warm welcome to you this morning as we celebrate the first Sunday after Trinity, and a special welcome to those who are listening from home. We say together, Almighty God, to whom all hearts are open, all desires are open, and from whom no secrets are hidden, cleanse the thoughts of our hearts by the inspiration of your Holy Spirit, that we may perfectly love you and worthily magnify your holy name, through Christ our Lord. Amen. My brothers and sisters, as we prepare to celebrate these holy mysteries, let us call to mind our sins. Almighty God, our Heavenly Father, we have sinned against you and against our neighbour, in thought and word and deed, through negligence, through weakness, through our own deliberate thought. We are truly sorry and repent of all our sins. For the sake of your Son, Jesus Christ, who died for us, forgive us all that is past, and grant that we may serve you in newness of life, to the glory of your name. Amen. Almighty God, who forgives all who truly repent, have mercy upon you, pardon and deliver you from all your sins, confirm and strengthen you in all goodness, and keep you in life eternal, through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. Of our mortal nature, we can do no good thing without you. Grant us the help of your grace, that in the keeping of your commandments, we may please you both in will and deed, through Jesus Christ, your Son, our Lord, who is alive and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, now and forever. Amen. Now Mary will read for us, so let us sit for the reading.
This is a reading from the book of Genesis. They heard the sound of the Lord God walking in the garden at the time of the evening breeze. And the man and his wife hid themselves from the presence of the Lord God among the trees of the garden. But the Lord God called to the man and said to him, "Where are you?" He said, "I heard the sound of you in the garden, and I was afraid because I was naked, and I hid myself." He said, "Who told you that you were naked? Have you eaten from the tree of which I commanded you not to eat?" The man said, The woman who you gave to be with me, she gave me fruit from the tree, and I ate. Then the Lord God said to the woman, what is this that you have done? The woman said, the serpent tricked me, and I ate. The Lord God said to the serpent, because you have done this, cursed are you among all animals and among all wild creatures. Upon your belly you shall go, and dust you shall eat all the days of your life. I will put enmity between you and the woman, and between your offspring and hers. He will strike your head, and you will strike his heel. This is the word of the Lord.
So that Jesus and the 12 could not even eat. When his family heard it, they went out to restrain him, for people were saying, he has gone out of his mind. And the scribes who came down from Jerusalem said, he has Beelzebul, and by the ruler of the demons he casts out demons. And he called them to him and spoke to them in parables. How can Satan cast out Satan? If a kingdom is divided against itself, that kingdom cannot stand. And if a house is divided against itself, that house will not be able to stand. And if Satan has risen up against himself and is divided, he cannot stand, but his end has come. But no one can enter a strong man's house and plunder his property without first tying up the strong man. Then indeed the house can be plundered. Truly I tell you, people will be forgiven for their sins and whatever blasphemies they utter. But whoever blasphemes against the Holy Spirit can never have forgiveness, but is guilty of an eternal sin. For they had said he has an unclean spirit. Then his mother and his brothers came, and standing outside, they sent to him and called him. A crowd was sitting around him, and they said to him, your mother and your brothers and sisters are outside asking for you. And he replied, who are my mother and my brothers? And looking at those who sat around him, he said, here are my mother and my brothers. Whoever does the will of God is my brother and sister and mother. This is the gospel of the Lord. I speak in the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. Lately, I've been thinking a lot about the nature of addiction, what causes it, how it's treated, and what we might do as Christian people and as the church to help those who suffer with it. The comedian Russell Brand speaks movingly about his history of drug addiction. He describes his abuse of illegal substances as a kind of holding pattern. The darkness in his life terrified him. At times it seemed like the monsters of his upbringing were threatening to overwhelm him. The temporary bursts of hope and happiness that drugs elicited
were just enough to stop him from sinking under the weight of his pain. They were his final defence against oblivion. They held back the night for just long enough to allow him to breathe and to live. For this reason, the thought of giving up drugs was terrifying. They were keeping him alive. Brand was like a shipwrecked man clinging to a piece of driftwood, too frightened to let go and swim for safety. His story is an extreme version of a common pattern. Life can be overwhelming. There can be forces inside us that we don't understand and that we can't seem to control. There can be skeletons in the closet that we are afraid to go near. When everything becomes too much, we often reach for survival strategies, a holding pattern, as Brand puts it, that will get us through the crisis, or perhaps just get us through the day or the next hour if the day is too awful to contemplate. But the holding pattern of addiction is parasitic. It can only sustain us in the present by consuming our future. And slowly but surely, this capital is exhausted. Brand was fortunate when he was finally forced by circumstance to face the demons of his upbringing. He found for the first time positive male role models to walk with him as he faced his fears and his wounds. And in facing the darkness, he found a spiritual light, a light that he is now exploring and trying to understand, a light in which he is beginning to find freedom. Jesus tells us in our Gospel reading that if a house is divided against itself, that house cannot stand. If there is a war going on in our mind, the solution is not to cower from the fight and seek refuge in holding patterns that at best offer a limited existence and at worst can be actively destructive, but instead to build the kind of relationships that will embolden us and strengthen us to carry our cross, to fight the good fight, and finally find freedom. It seems to me that in the first instance, this means building a friendship with Jesus. St. Paul tells us, "We too believe, and therefore we too speak, knowing that he who raised the Lord Jesus to life will raise us with Jesus in our turn, and put us by his side, and you with us." In his resurrection, Jesus conquered sin and death. He showed us that he is victorious over all evil, including the darkness in your life and in mine. If we form a friendship, a relationship with Jesus, then we embrace the love that casts out all fear and the love that can break every chain. The road might be long. We will always have to carry our cross. But if we remain united to Christ, we will face our fears armed with a light that the darkness can never overcome. Paul reminds us that if we stand firm with Jesus, then though this outer person of ours may be falling into decay, the inner person is renewed day by day. If the best part of us is continually renewed in Christ and in the Spirit, then we will find freedom in this life or the next. Once we begin our friendship with Christ, we need to become active members of Jesus' family. We heard Jesus declare in our Gospel reading, "Who are my mother and my brothers?" And looking around at those sitting in a circle about him, he said, "Here are my mother and my brothers. Anyone who does the will of God, that person is my brother and sister and mother." The will of God is that we love one another as Jesus has loved us. We manifest our adoption into God's family when, like Jesus, we live not for ourselves but for others. Empowered by the Spirit and in union with Jesus, we can become a gift of God to other people. If we allow God to love us, he can work through us such that we become a blessing to those around us. There is a deep joy and a deep happiness in knowing that we make the lives of others more bearable by our care and service. In loving others, we so often discover that we too are much more lovable than we ever dared to imagine. When our love is inspired by God, we glimpse the awesome love that our Heavenly Father has for us as his beloved children. A love that enfolds us, even when we do not love ourselves. A love that is true and good, that conquers all things and is without end.
We believe in one God, the Father, the Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, of all that is seen and unseen. We believe in one Lord, Jesus Christ, the only Son of God, eternally begotten of the Father, God from God, light from light, true God from true God, begotten, not made, of one being with the Father. Through him all things were made. For us and for our salvation, he came down from heaven, was incarnate from the Holy Spirit and the Virgin Mary, and was made man. For our sake, he was crucified under Pontius Pilate. He suffered death and was buried. On the third day, he rose again, in accordance with the Scriptures. He ascended into heaven, and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again in glory to judge the living and the dead, and his kingdom will have no end. We believe in the Holy Spirit, the Lord, the giver of life, who proceeds from the Father and the Son, who with the Father and the Son is worshipped and glorified, who has spoken through the prophets. We believe in one holy Catholic and apostolic church. We acknowledge one baptism for the forgiveness of sins. We look for the resurrection of the dead and the life of the world to come. Amen. So let us pray. Let us pray for the church and for the world, giving thanks to God for his goodness.
Heavenly Father, as we come before you this day, we give thanks to you for the wonder and the beauty of your creation and for all that you have done in our lives. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. We bring before you this day all who suffer from any kind of addiction, those whose lives are ruined because of others' cruelty, those who struggle to get through the day, the next hour, the next 5 minutes. And we ask, Lord, that you will enfold them in your loving embrace and help them to know that they are loved by you and valued by you. Teach us, Lord, to value them too. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. We pray for the church throughout the world, but especially here in the Diocese of Lincoln, as it undergoes change. We pray for our bishops, Christopher, David, and Nicholas, for our Archdeacon, Mark, for our Rural Dean, Nick, and for all who serve here on the team the parish of Great Grimsby. We pray for our future and ask that we may be guided by you, that your Holy Spirit will lead us into all things true and good. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. We pray for our community here in Grimsby, for all who live and work and have their being within the parish boundaries. We pray that we will always be good neighbours to one another, always willing to listen and lend a helping hand. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. And we pray for all who suffer, body, mind or spirit, those who have asked for our prayers. We remember today Wendy and Derek, Jan, Ken and Pat. We pray for Stephen, for George, Barbara, Zoe, Roger, Andy, Tony, Mary, for Richard, Kiara, and Sarah, and Jacqueline. Be their consolation, Lord, we pray, and bring healing to them. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. And we pray for all who have died. We pray for those who have died in the night, and for those who will die this day, either alone, by violence, or by their own hand. And we ask that they may be with you this day in paradise. We remember all who mourn, and those whose anniversaries fall at this time. Rest eternal grant unto them, O Lord, and let light perpetual shine upon them. May they rest in peace and rise in glory. Amen. And so we join our prayers together with those of the Blessed Virgin and St. Hugh, as we say, Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners now and at the hour of our death. Amen. Merciful Father, accept these prayers for the sake of your Son, our Saviour, Jesus Christ. Amen.
And now we come to the peace. Christ is our peace. He has reconciled us to God in one body by the cross. We meet in his name and share his peace. The peace of the Lord be always with you. Let us offer one another a sign of peace.
Thank you.
blessed are you, Lord God of all creation. For your goodness we have this bread set before you, which earth has given and human hands have made. It will become for us the bread of life. Blessed are you, Lord God of all creation. For your goodness we have this wine set before you, fruit of the vine and work of human hands. It will become for us the cup of salvation. Lord God, let the offering we dedicate to your name cleanse us and reshape us day by day for the new life of your kingdom, through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. The Lord be with you. Lift up your hearts. Let us give thanks to the Lord our God. Father, we give you thanks and praise through your beloved Son, Jesus Christ, your living Word, through whom you have created all things, who was sent by you in your great goodness to be our Saviour. By the power of the Holy Spirit, he took flesh as your Son. Born of the Blessed Virgin, he lived on earth and went about among us. He opened wide his arms to us on the cross. He put an end to death by dying for us, and revealed the resurrection by rising to new life. So he fulfilled your will and won for you a holy people. Therefore, with angels and archangels, and with all the company of heaven, we proclaim your great and glorious name, forever praising you and singing. Lord, you are holy indeed, the source of all holiness. Grant that by the power of your Holy Spirit, and according to your holy will, these gifts of bread and wine may be to us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ, who, in the same night that he was betrayed, took bread and gave it thanks. He broke it and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take, eat. This is my body, which is given for you. Do this in remembrance of me." In the same way, after supper, he took the cup and gave you thanks. He gave it to them, saying, "Drink this, all of you. This is my blood of the new covenant, which is shed for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this as often as you drink it, in remembrance of me." Great is the mystery of faith. Christ has died, Christ is risen, Christ will come again. So, Father, calling to mind his death on the cross, His perfect sacrifice made once for the sins of the whole world, rejoicing in his mighty resurrection and glorious ascension, and looking for his coming in glory, we celebrate this memorial of our redemption. As we offer you this, our sacrifice of praise and thanksgiving, we bring before you this bread and this cup, and we thank you for counting us worthy to stand in your presence and serve you. Send the Holy Spirit on your people, and gather into one in your kingdom all who share this one bread and one cup, so that we, in the company of Mary, the Mother of God, St. James, St. Mark, St. Martin, and St. Hugh, and all the saints, may praise and glorify you forever through Jesus Christ our Lord. By whom, and with whom, and in whom, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all honour and glory be yours, Almighty Father, for ever and ever. Amen. As our Saviour taught us, so we pray. Our Father in heaven, hallowed be your name. Your kingdom come, your will be done on earth as in heaven. Give us today our daily bread. Forgive us our sins as we forgive those who sin against us. Lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever. Amen. We break this bread to share in the body of Christ. Though we are one, we are one body, because we all share in one bread. Here is the Lamb of God that takes away the sin of the world. Happy are those who are called to his supper. Lord, I am not worthy to receive you, but only say the word, and I shall be healed. Let us pray. Eternal Father, we thank you for nourishing us with these heavenly gifts. May our communion strengthen us in faith, build us up in hope, and make us grow in love for the sake of Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. Almighty God, we thank you for feeding us with the body and blood of your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him we offer you our souls and bodies to be a living sacrifice. Send us out in the power of your Spirit to live and work for your praise and glory. Amen.
Good morning to you once again, and a very warm welcome to you too. It's been lovely to have you with us today. There aren't many notices as far as I'm aware this morning. You should have the notice sheet, which will give you all the information that you'll need for the coming week. This evening at 6 o'clock, there will be a service of choral evensong, and you can find that online on our social media pages. So that will be a service online and not here at the Minster. During the week, on Thursday at 11 o'clock, there will be a live Mass here in the Minster. That's 11 o'clock on Thursday, so do come along and join us if you're able to. You will be very, very welcome indeed. Thanks to our choir this morning for those lovely pieces of music today. Today is actually Music Day, I understand. So if you get the opportunity, do collar one of the choir and say thank you to them for all that they do to help us in leading our worship, and then perhaps go home and put on something rather splendid to listen to this afternoon.
Would you please stand? The Lord be with you. Let's bow our heads and pray for God's blessing. The peace of God, which passes all understanding, keep your hearts and minds in the knowledge and love of God, and of his Son, Jesus Christ, our Lord. And the blessing of God Almighty, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit, be among you and remain with you always. Amen. Amen. Go in peace to love and serve the Lord.
In the name of Christ.
Thank you. Minister's ministry and mission has never been more needed. Meeting online or in church for prayer services and fellowship, loving our neighbours by offering practical support to the vulnerable, and caring for our communities. The work of our church is reliant on people's generosity, and we are so grateful for all the gifts we receive. This generosity is a hallmark of a lived out faith and a testament to it. If you are able to give to us now, here's how you can help.